Reminence and Reverend Fathers, I want to thank you for this opportunity to speak to you. So we live in a time of monsters. I announce this to you, but I think all of you already know that. We only need to glance at popular culture to realize this. At the narrative level of our culture and our stories, we've become obsessed with monsters, with the strange, alien, with the marginal, with the glorification of the exception, of things that don't fit. Most of us here probably grew up with Sesame Street, where we were told that monsters are our friends. And it's no longer in fiction by now. The monsters have left the dark spaces under our beds. They have left our nightmares to come out into the open. At a social level, we can feel and see all around us the growing polarization, the acceleration of what we can only call the breakdown, the decomposition of culture, the progressive dissipation of the center, which rallies us as a society. And in thinking about this, it's difficult not to reminisce. It's difficult not to meditate on the famous poem by Yeats, The Second Coming. We tend to go back to that poem because it seems, at least in our more frightening moments, we get the feeling that the horrific cycle of the 20th century is on our horizon again.
Turning and turning in the widening gyre, the falcon cannot hear the falconer. Things fall apart, the center cannot hold. Mere anarchy is loosed upon the world. The blood-dimmed tide is loosed and everywhere. The ceremony of innocence is drowned.
The ceremony of innocence is drowned. The best lack all conviction, while the worst are full of passionate intensity. The monsters have left the dark spaces under our beds. They have left our nightmares to come out into the open. At a social level, we can feel and see all around us the growing polarization, the acceleration of what we can only call the breakdown, the decomposition of culture, a progressive dissipation of the center, which rallies us as a society. Poem, of which I've quoted the first part, is probably one of the most known in modern poetry, the most cited. I think it's actually the most anthologized poem there is. And it rings so true that we stand here in that widening gyre, at the edge of the world where the wheel is spinning so fast, feels as if it's going to come off its axis.
Couched in a
corpse. The zombie inhabits the indeterminate space of living death, roaming around in pack. The zombie shows us the mindless wandering of the mindless mob. The mindless wandering of the mindless mob. With an insatiable hunger for devouring others, for swallowing life. The zombie shows us mindless wandering of the mindless mob. With an insatiable hunger for devouring others, for swallowing life. If the vampire is the monster of aristocracy, the zombie is the monster of the mass, the demos, the monster of the accidental, of quantitative leveling. The zombie is the atheist insistent on the illusion of free will. It's an image of nihilism and idiosyncrasy taken all the way to decomposition. In every major city in North America, they have these events. They call them zombie walks. People dress up as zombies and walk in the thousands down the streets, dressed up and made up to look like corpses, shifting around with dead, empty eyes, pretending to be the walking dead.
Soulless, desiring death machine.